Why, it's Janice.
And Damien too.
Ooh.
Yes, this is check-in. We're gonna check our bags then.
Oh my god. I'm so excited. I can't cope. This doesn't feel real. I've only been on 3 aeroplanes in my life. 2 and from New York last time I went, and once from Manchester to London. They were both over 8 years ago, so I like don't remember, and I'm shook right now, to say the least.
Things are gonna get better from here. Take a gulp. Ooh, child, things are gonna get from here.
So we have just got to Newark.
Yes, we have. We're at the air rail.
And we've just got some tickets to Port Authority. So we have to get an air rail to Penn Station. And then we get one to Penn Station.
Yes, and then from Penn Station we need to probably get a taxi.
Maybe. Apparently we can walk, I think. Maybe. It's very sweaty. It's very, very warm. It's like 32 degrees.
We're about as shook as people can be.
Literally, I just sat here like...
Oh my god. We're on our way into central New York to Manhattan to go and do a Mean Girls lottery. Does it get any better?
The answer is no.
I feel like, you know, in Funny Girl when she's on the boat and she's like, don't tell me not to live, just sit and put up. Because we're like, there's nothing in front of us. We just on the train on our own, and it's like the best thing ever. We're talking to people who are American, and we're just like, oh my god, you're American. And we're just like the most basic bitches that have ever been alive. But we're excited, you know? Ah! I can't seem to see Manhattan anymore.
Over there.
Over there. Manhattan's over there. Can you see? Can you see, Mom?
Can you see,
excited. Cautionary tale. A fear and lust and pride based on actual events where people die.
No,
we're so hyper. Oh my god.
We are in a yellow cab.
Louise just goes, oh my god, it's a McDonald's. Okay, hon.
So you're like, Amy, where are you? Well, where do you think I am? I'm at Times Square. We are just outside SpongeBob right now, which we are seeing next week.
Oh, look at
this. Times Square. I'm pretty sure. We're gonna go and do the Mean Girls lottery today. But I feel like weirdly comfortable vlogging here. I feel really weird about it in London, but here I am and I'm loving my life. I also wanna find a 7-Eleven.
You can sit with us.
Mean Girls! Kids, here we are at the August Wilson Theatre. I'm gonna show you. That's Kerry Butler.
Because of B, you look beautiful.
I never stage door, never hang around a theatre.
But this week...
I never lose my shit.
But this week...
We're doing it.
Yeah, we are.
I believe that this is the stage door here. Then there's like a pink thing, then there's a pink door. And then we walk along and we have some information.
Welcome to North Shore High.
Then we have the queens, the queen, the goddess.
Oh.
The lottery begins at like 4:30 and it's currently 3:05. So we're super duper early. There's a 7-Eleven right there.
These stores the same.
I'm gonna get a 7-Eleven slush because I am Heather's trash. So you just fill it up yourself? Surely this is so dangerous. Right, what do I do? How do I do this? Oh my god, what the hell?
Oh my god, this is so weird.
Okay friends, so we were like, let's just see what's around the block. So we walked a little further, we found a 7-Eleven. Obviously you've just seen that. I've just got my first ever slushy. And it is truly and utterly epic. I can't even cope. I'm having such a good time. So we're just entering the lottery. So here is our lottery card. This is the card, like your name and how many tickets you want and whatever. So my friend Donna is in New York. She has come to see the final performances of Hello Dolly. And she went to go and see a matinee and literally ran here. And she's basically the best person in the entire world.
I'm here.
What a queen, what a queen.
And Brandon just needed one ticket, so I'm gonna say thanks, Brandon!
Thanks, Brandon! So I'm very behind on vlogging because like we've just had a bit of a mental time. So we didn't win the Mean Girls lottery. Boo. And then we got in the like return queue. And Lewis was offered tickets for tonight for a really good price and he turned them down. Were they singles?
They were two singles.
Two singles. So then we went in anyway and we were like, oh well, what have you got for tomorrow? We managed to get two tickets together. So we are doing that instead tomorrow. And tonight we are seeing Waitress!
Sugar, butter,
flyer! We need to stop. We went for dinner with our friend Donna.
Whoever a wonderful dinner was, it was very five star place.
Yeah, we McDonald's. Went to McDonald's.
We had a McBang at McDonald's.
McBunk.
Sugar, butter,
flyer! NYC. Just got here this morning. $3. $2. One me.
Sorry. What is that? I'm doing a takeover on Amy's vlog. So I bought a program and a poster. Came to about $40. We're looking at getting some pie as well. It's our first Broadway show of the trip. I'm super excited.
Good morning. Hello. How are you? I'm really sorry that I didn't finish my vlog last night. I was so tired and just like completely run down that I just thought I can't do this. Are you all right, Louis? I was awake for like an hour before we spoke, and I heard Louis' tongue pop. And I was like, oh my god, he tongue pops in his sleep. He's like the ultimate gay icon, you know? I tongue popped to see if you were awake. So, for God's sake. Waitress. Oh my goodness. I have so many thoughts on it. Like, the girl who's previously been the understudy. She was amazing. She was seriously incredible. Her voice was just, it was very similar to Jesse Mueller's voice, I thought.
But it was like,
really country-y.
I said it was like Jesse Mueller times 100.
Yeah, she was just incredible. And Drew, I want to say, I've always heard Gerling, I think. Or Gerling. The guy who played the original Dr. Pomada. He was back in the show and he was incredible. Please marry me. Obviously, I've been to Broadway before, but it was a long time ago and I sat in really awful seats, like super far away. And I don't really remember it. So I've had this view of Broadway for all these years. Like that, obviously we've got amazing talent on the West End and stuff, but I always think of Broadway as being like so much more. And I think Stephanie and Drew were incredible, but I think every single other person in the cast is like the same level as what we've got on the West End. And that's not like lowering what the Broadway people are doing, but really like speaking up about the people on the West End, because I often think like, you know, it is like a completely different ball game. And I think specifically of what I saw last night, any West End cast would be able to do that as well. And that like both was good in my mind, but also sad because I was expecting to see something that was like, that blew me away to like a different level. Loved the show and I had a great experience like I would if I went to see something amazing on the West End. But it just is like more commercial and whatnot here, and I don't know, I just had lots of thoughts about it. Everybody at the theatre was so, so nice. Like, it was
the audience, you
like that. Yeah, the audience, oh my god, people just kept getting up and going to the toilet and I was like, are you all right? Like, what's that about? Probably 15 people got up in the orchestra stalls area in the first act and I'm like, what's wrong with you? And then there's people like walking in late and they're like, oh, where am I sitting? What? I was really, really quite horrified by the behavior of the audience. But I thought Waitress overall was beautiful, like such a gorgeous show. I'm really, really excited to see it on the West End now. Yeah, because we didn't win Mean Girls last night and then there were no tickets left. We're seeing it tonight, which I'm so excited about. And I think that's better as well because I was so tired when we saw the show last night that I kept thinking like, if I was seeing Mean Girls right now, would I be able to enjoy it as much as I want to? Do you know what I mean? Well, what else is there to say about Waitress? I feel like I have so many thoughts and opinions.
I enjoyed it so much more than I thought I was going to.
Yeah.
I've always loved the music. Like, that without a doubt was always going to be a good point for me. But even the story and the physical theatre elements have been so many levels. Like, the amount of times that I turned to Amy, I was just shook.
Yeah, it's like Hamilton all over again. I wish I hadn't seen the bootleg. But anyway, I'm running out of battery, so I'm gonna go. We're going to see Mean Girls and watch tomorrow's vlog or whenever it goes up. Yes, I'll see you soon, bye.